So my helper had to come out and see what was going on. So here's the piece that I made out of that 16th of an inch piece of steel. It took me 15 minutes to make this. I just used jigsaw and cut to my scribe line. You know, it's not perfect, but it's going to be just fine. And here, watch out, Papa. And so that just fits in here. It's a little. I made it just with a little bit of slop in it. So the lift will now sit down on top of it. And so what I can do now is I can pull a measurement off this cast iron top with the calipers. And so I'll know how deep I need to route plus 1 millimeter. That's what I'm gonna route. Okay, well, I'm about ready to make this happen. I had to make a small adjustment on this. I got it almost the very first time, but it was just a little sloppier than I wanted, so I had to bring it in about a half a millimeter. And so I really like this size right here. So it's just enough that I can get this in here without damaging, you know, the laminate edge. And I traced onto that piece of steel, and then here's my I don't even know what to call this. I'm calling it a tray. You know, this is going to be the steel tray that the set screws are going to sit on. And so I've got all these set screw locations around here. And then here, this is what's going to pin this to the bottom corner of the table. So when I you know, keep it from lifting after I get this set in position. So it's going to have a lot of ability to, you know, these guys will push on the side to make sure that it can't jiggle this way. Set screws will raise and lower it and level it, and then after I get it in there, I'll just drill through, mark that through my tray and drill down into that corner, and I'll just put a corner bracket on it. There's some real nice countersunk bolts that'll go in the four corners. So I've got it level, side to side, can't move there, can't shift if they're, you know, if the router bucks, and then it can't lift out because of this. So I think I've got it covered. Now, here, let me take this off. So this is a 16th of an inch steel here, and it is 3/8. And so it's actually less than a 16th. Let me see. I can't remember yet. Let me look at this. What do we got? No, it's just a fat 16th over. So this must be a gauge steel. I thought it was a 16th, but it's just ever so slightly over. So when I put these two together, this is definitely 3/8. So when I put these two together, if I route down, this is a half inch, this square right here. So if I route down exactly a half inch, that leaves me 1 millimeter of set down that I can have some slop and some play with. And, you know, because I'm trying to keep from taking as much, I don't want to take very much material out, take as little as possible out of the plywood. Yeah, that's right on exactly 1 millimeter. So what I'm doing here is, you know, I've got my plunge router here that I'm going to do all the cutting with. And so I took a piece of the short extrusion that matches this Festool multifunction jig, and I put it up here. And then I put this up here and I set my depth. That is absolutely perfect right there. So, I mean, I have some adjustment. I'm just trying to remove as little material as possible. Okay, so I feel confident that that's good. Now, one of the issues that I have here, if you look at my template, is the, you know, my practice piece that I cut, is the radius. And I've seen this in other router jigs too, so they must, you know, it must be a very large bit that they're using that they expect you to use here. And so I'm using a 1-inch bit, and you can see that I've got this pretty unsightly gap at the corners, and I just can't have that. I can't tolerate that. Is it, well, for one thing, that's where a little junk's going to get trapped down in there, and so I'm not going to do it. So here what I'm going to do is, when I route this, I just cut a few of these pieces on the table saw, and I'm just going to, the bushing guide's going to hit that, and it's going to stop me from cutting into these corners, and I'll cut to depth and, you know, the whole nine yards. Then after that, I'll take the jig off, I'll take this template off, and then I'll just come back in, put the actual thing down into, you know, exactly, and I'll just scribe into the laminate, and then I'll just freehand with that bit, because I'll have very little material to remove. So the way I'm doing this, just so it's not going to get flung away when I'm routing, just putting a piece of tape on that little tenon, and then I back it and go the other direction. And that's sticking out too much, so I'll just cut that off. And just stick it into the corner, and just keep my eye out to make sure that I haven't, that I'm not gonna wing it off. But you know, that's gonna just keep the router from cutting all the way to that corner. So I'll just do this. Take the jig off, I will have cut to depth, and then I just kind of, I'll just scribe that and then freehand the rest. Because if all I have to do is just follow that radius, I can do that really easily with the router. Okay, so I think I'm ready to cut down into this guy.